Good morning, students. Today we have a discussion on the topic of design of hydraulic and pneumatic circuit for various manufacturing application machines. Especially in this video, we have two machines we have to discuss. One will be the shaping machine, and other one will be the drilling machine. Shaping machine is powered by means of an hydraulic circuit. Again, the drilling machine is powered by the pneumatic circuit. First of all, we go for a shaping machine and then go for a drilling machine. In this shaping machine, we know the working of a shaping machine will be. Here, the workpiece will be in stationary one, again, tool will be the moving one. Again, tool is attached to the tool post, and then the tool post is connected to the ram. That ram will be goes to and fro motion. Either it can be on electrical, pneumatic, or hydraulic. Here we are discussing about the hydraulic to and fro motion of the shaping machine ram. Again, what are the here? First, we have go for what are the equipments are used here. LS and LF1 and LS2 indicates the limiting switch. What is the extreme end of it will be in goes front and extreme end of it goes reverse. Again, this will be the weight limit. Again, this is the flow control valve. Again, 2x4 direction control valve is using here. Again, F1 is L2 is control. It means that solenoid 1 and solenoid 2, it will be getting input from the limiting switches. Again, pressure control valve, pump, and pump is driven with the help of a motor. Again, tank. Here, stop from the tank. The fluid which is containing the fluid does not have any pressure. That unpressurized fluid is getting into the pump and it will be getting pressure. If the fluid is getting overpressure, that overpressurized fluid is getting out of the circuit by means of a pressure regulation valve and return back to the tank. Pressurized fluid when we enter into the direction control valve, the direction control is controlled by the solenoid by means of a limited switches. When the piston is or piston connected rod is connected at these ends, the limiting switch 1 will be acting and then solenoid will be acting on this and then limiting the switches to the next position. So first we go for a first question. Pressurized fluid is entering into direction by means of a flow control valve. Again, the return portion does not have any motion. So the return stroke having a free motion, again as well as the faster movement of a ram. So return stroke of a machine having the faster stroke compared to the forward stroke. The forward stroke will be slower and return stroke will be faster because the forward stroke having the flow control valve and the return side of the fluid. So it cannot be easily flow the fluid to the tank. It will be control the pressure as well as the flow towards the tank in the position 2. So it having some slower motion is generating on the front side. Again, return side it has a faster motion because it has the time gaining flow control valve. So the faster the retardation motion and the slower the forward motion is available, it will be helpful for a smoother cutting of a material. This is a simple circuit for a separation. Then go for a. These are the theories behind the design of a hydraulic circuit for a shaping machine. Go for a pneumatic circuit. When we compare to the hydraulic circuit, pneumatic circuit is very lesser weight and easier to run because it doesn't have any tank circuit or anything. The fresher air is getting from the air and it will be compressed by means of compressor and it will be utilized by the any equipment and it will be returned to the environment by means of people. So it doesn't have any tank circuit. Any other, so it will be a lesser in weight, lesser in environmental impact, all other parts very easier. And directly go for a pneumatic circuit. And first of all, pneumatic drill.
Yes, of no hydraulic circuit is we have actuate hydraulic actuators are only seen, the hydraulic cylinders are only thing here, but here hydraulic pneumatic actuator is a vane motor. The vane motor here. The purpose of vane motor is to convert the pressurized the hydraulic pneumatic air is converted into mechanical motion by means of vane motor. The vane motor or vane type rotor is directly opposite to the pump. Pump is nothing but conversion of electrical motion into mechanical work. That mechanical work is converted into some pressurized fluid. Here, the pressurized fluid is getting into the rotor conversion, then it will convert it into directly mechanical motion. The pressurized fluid is entering into this rotor type, again that rotor is converted into that air is getting into the vane motor. That vane motor is getting rotated by means of pressurized air, and that pressurized air will be helpful for the rotation of the rotor, and that motor is coupled to the gear system. That gear system is responsible for the multiplication of forces or multiplication of speeds and multiplication of torque based upon the which gear is applicable on that. Again, that multiplication of forces will be getting into the workpiece by means of a chuck and then drill bit which is attached here. Okay. So when we are giving a force here, automatically the torque speed will be reducing, torque will be increasing, as well as the movement of a motion will be increasing. Again, this bearing will be responsible for the impact force which is applied on the workpiece is getting into the motion. It will be the bearing will be responsible for reduction of damage of gear system as well as the main rotor system. Pneumatic application of pneumatic application of hydraulic pneumatic drill is entirely differ from hydraulic circuit, because the hydraulic circuit is only applicable for a to and fro motion, but in terms of electronic pneumatic drill, it will be responsible for an any circular kind of things along, not only in the pneumatic. This type of same circuit, instead of a drill bit, we can go for a screw and nut system for. Okay, for example, this type of application is heavy nut spanner application is we have seen in the mechanical workshop, something like that. The heavy equipments like something lorry or buses will be. Lorry tires will be removed by means of a pneumatic chuck remover. This is a very very easier or frequently used application in all the mechanical workshops we have seen a lot. Okay, and again this is some of the simple pneumatic drills only. We go for an heavier or extremely higher rated application in terms of next video. Thank you.